What is up, my peeps? Caliber724 here with another video for you guys today. So, I was basically checking my comments and all that stuff, and I actually got a comment from one of my long-time subscribers. He's been with the channel for a very long time. He actually requested this video, so shout out to you. You know who you are, JV. He's basically the first person who was actually requesting videos back when I was very small, like, you know, I think like 50 something subscribers. But yeah, also I got another comment saying they wanted me to show, I guess, like a beginner setup of what like how somebody could start a perk TV farm. And in this video I will actually show you guys how to do that, or actually I'll tell you, not necessarily show you. You can watch my other video, my first Perk TV Farm video, to kind of see how to set it up. But I'll basically be telling you how to do it. Kind of like some devices I recommend. But let's go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna cut it right here and I'm gonna show you guys what my Perk TV Farm is right now at this current moment. After that video, I will tell you why that is. So now you see that my Perk TV Farm is basically digital. There's no devices, only one computer. Now in this video clip that I showed you, there's basically just like three windows open for Perk TV, and then I just had like, you know, the little, my banner and everything like that down there, so you just kind of like know what my channel is. But basically the reason why this is because, like I explained in another video, if you saw the action cam vlogging and live update, I explained in that video like all my tech has just been dying on me. So like the phones that I was using for my Perk Farm went out. They don't even charge. Maybe it could contribute to, I always had them on the charger. Maybe that can contribute to it. And I'll explain a little bit more on that when I explain how to set it up and everything like that and what I've learned from it. But basically, so it's basically all digital for me right now. And also, when I had my Perk Farm here at home, I had a problem with not being able to control, like, when, like, usually it'll be running from the morning to like midday, and then within midday it'll come up with that screen that says, are you still watching? And then I had no one to actually, you know, I guess someone to kind of keep manage it, basically. So because it'll ask you if you're still watching after a certain amount of time, and if you don't interact with it, it'll basically just sit there and you won't earn any points. So I didn't have anybody to manage that for me. And then when I got home, then I would do it, and then it would just run all through the night while I'm asleep. And then when I'm asleep in the middle of the night, it would go to that are you still watching screen again. So what I figure is, if I have it at work while I'm working, like as you've seen on the screen, it had all my little Perk TV pages up playing the videos. Once it goes to are you still watching, all I do is check periodically, like maybe increments of like 30 minutes. And with that, all I have to do is just go and check. And if it says, are you still watching? It minimizes the time that it sits there. So every day I earn about, well, on a good day, I can run about like 5 Chrome tabs, you know, 5 of those little boxes that you saw there playing the video. So I could run 5 of those on a good day. Today was not such a good day. For some reason, if I added more than 3 pages, then most of the tabs will crash and the plugins will fail or something like that. I know I read up on, did some research on it, and I know that happens a lot with Chrome. So I'm not necessarily sure, but maybe it happens on Internet Explorer, maybe it happens on other browsers, but as far as I know, that happens on Chrome, but I use Chrome most of the time. So that's just something that I have to deal with. And plus, Chrome is the main internet that we use at the job, or that I use at least, or I prefer. So that's basically my PerkTV Farm update portion. All digital. On a bad day like today, only be able to run 3 pages at the most. On a very good day, I'll be able to run like 5 pages at the most. And then every day I will earn from about like, for each tab, I will earn about like 250 points per tab for an 8-hour period. And that's good. So if every day I was able to run 4 tabs, 1,000 points a day, which will mean 5,000 points a week. A month, 30,000. So that's good. It's good. All right, so as far as the PerkTV Farm startup and how to get started with a PerkTV Farm, I suggest you start out with devices that you already have that you may not use, like old phones that you had from any old plans that you had. Like, for instance, in my video, I had the first Samsung Tab 10.1. That I had since long ago. And as you've seen in the video, the screen was like cracked up and all that stuff. You know, I mean, it still worked as far as the touch display. Recently, the touch display has not been responding that well. But, you know, I put it to use how I could. Then I had the HTC One. Then I had the Samsung Galaxy S4. Then I had the LG Lumen or something like that. I think that was from MetroPCS. The Samsung and the HTC was, I think, was from Sprint. And then the tablet was actually from just no carrier. It was just like a tablet that I bought from community college. So with that, basically you start out with the devices that you have. You know, you can, I believe it's 5 devices, but I did get a comment saying that you can have up to like, or that the person had like 15 devices running PerkTV or whatever, and you can have up to a specific amount as long as you don't go over a specific amount of points within a specific amount of time. So I guess it's like, you know, they limit how much you earn within a specific amount of time. So with that, start out with the devices that you have. You know, you may have just like 3 or 4 devices. That's still good. If they work and they're able to use Wi-Fi, a Wi-Fi signal, then you should be good. With these Perk devices, I suggest that they are only used for that specific purpose, which is Perk. If they're going to be running Perk and you want them to be money earning machines, then that's what they need to be. Like, for me, I had my main phone also in that, but I didn't show it in the video mainly because, you know, that's my main phone. So it's not going to be running Perk all the time. That's just like my main phone. So the devices that was shown in that video was mainly for that purpose of being a Perk form, Perk TV form, I mean to say. But also, what I do recommend is you get a, just like a cheap phone that's able to be, it's like Wi-Fi compatible. This right here is a $20 phone from Track Phone. Right now it's my main phone, but you know, I do try and use it as far as like Perk TV, but Track Phone is not the best because you only get like, what, 500 megabytes of data, which I'm not even sure how long that would probably just run, like probably a day of Perk TV, which is not that great. But if you have Wi-Fi and you have like a cheap phone like this, small phone, it's not high quality video and all that stuff. So I'm assuming it wouldn't take much to run the Perk TV ads and stuff like that, because it's less data with a lower quality. So one, get your devices. Mainly start out with devices that you already have. Two, if you want to go along the lines of paying for a device, get something that is not way too old. I'm not talking about like way back, but something that's modern enough to where it can support the latest version of Perk TV. Like this here, I think it's like, it's running Android 5.01, I think. So it's running Android 5, or the little software or whatever. But, you know, it's running Android 5, and it can run the latest version of Perk TV. You know, so that's still good. Next thing you're going to need is Wi-Fi or some type of internet connection to actually run, you know, the Perk TV app. Mainly you want to go for Wi-Fi because you can connect multiple devices to one Wi-Fi hotspot. But as far as like if you have a carrier or something like that, you're going to be paying out money to make money, which is not, that's no good. You want to be able to limit the cost that you're paying. So if you're paying for a plan to run Perk TV, not a good deal. If you have a Wi-Fi hotspot to actually run Perk TV for free, unlimited amount of time, all go. So for that, also, you want to, on your phone, for Perk TV, you want to go into your settings, set your phone to low bandwidth video. And that what's that gonna do is, it's basically gonna make the video so it uses less data to actually, you know, play the video. So it's gonna play the video at a lower quality. I think what that will do is, one, make the video play at a lower quality. Two, it won't take up as much bandwidth on that Wi-Fi server. So you want to do that. And then also you want to set the video quality to low. So that's going to help also. Not sure if you can do it on the smartphone app, but I know on the website you can set like the video quality to low, medium, high, and then tablet. I think they just added that feature in. But all in all, that's basically what you want to have. You want to start out with devices that you already have if you're not using them, or if they're not being used by anyone. If you have somebody who can just give you a old phone that they not using anymore that can run the latest version of Perk, cool, free, you know. But if you want to buy phones, buy something that's not going to be like very high end, because you don't want to shell out all the money for something that's just going to be sitting there playing video, you know. So like this, once again, this phone is not a high end phone, but it can still play video, can run the latest version of Perk. So, you know, it works. So I would suggest, and this is like, this was like $20. You can, with that, I think each point is worth 1 cent. So 2,000 points will be $20, I believe, depending on how you spend it to get the gift cards. Also, I saw some people have like some rigs as far as like their charging setup. I know I mentioned earlier in the video about me, you know, the phone's not charging or whatever. Maybe the battery got, I guess, overcharged and it just didn't want to charge anymore. I saw some people with setups where they have a special outlet that turns on and turns off automatically throughout like a set period of time. Like maybe they'll have it set for 5 hours, or maybe they'll have it set for like 2 hours. But I'm not sure how much that costs. Generally, you can go all digital like I have, or you can go with the physical devices. I think there's an advantage to having the devices, mainly because you won't necessarily have to worry about the issues with Chrome or the issues with the web browsers shutting down if you have too many up there. As opposed to having the devices, it's a lot to manage a lot of devices. Like I know the guy over at the Tech Slugs, how I got started was I was watching his videos about how to start like making money from my smartphone devices and stuff like that. And I saw that he was doing Perk, and he had like a little Perk farm up there and everything like that. I don't think he necessarily went in detail with it, but he was just telling what each phone does, how it runs throughout the day, what he does with all the phones and stuff like that. And you know, that's what I got from that. But as far as the charging situation, find a good way to not overcharge the battery, because I know I did see a couple of comments that were like, well, that's a fire hazard, which it is, because if the phone is charging constantly, the phone is going to get hot. So especially since we have carpet in here, that could start a fire. So in a sense, I was lucky that the phones went out, but at the same time, you know, with that, you know, I have to be stuck to the limit of how much the server can handle as far as like, you know, the Chrome and everything like that. So but yeah, so that's basically the charging situation. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a big old thumbs up. Once again, shout out to JV, one of my longtime subscribers. Been here since the beginning. Not that many subscribers when he came around. I think he was around since the beginning. And then shout out to, I think her name was Kat, or the person's name was Kat Furio. Thanks for asking the question, suggesting that I kind of help out with that. I do like having conversations with you guys. I do like helping you guys out, helping you figure stuff out. You know, if I say something wrong in my videos, or I say, you know, or do something wrong in my videos, I want you guys to let me know also, you know, constructive criticism. We're all here to help each other, and that's what it's all about. So yeah, that's about it. Don't forget to be brilliant. Stay inspired. Stay inspired. That's all you can do these days. Be brilliant, stay inspired. You know what it is. Yeah, you know what it is. Peace.